Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sharafil anbiya wal mursaleen wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Alhamdulillah, with the grace, mercy, love and guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with his permission, bi'iznillah, we continue our da'wah to train 12,000 PIP life coaches. Through our YouTube channel, we have more than 600 videos and many channels, including now we are doing Ilmu Kalam, Ilmu Tauhid, Kalam Cosmology, where we talk about Kalam, Cosmological Argument. We have Islamic Psychology, PIP, and many other videos on motivation. The whole idea is we want to transform the Ummah, especially the young people, to be able to do da'wah relevant to the 21st century in terms of Islamic motivation, coaching, mentoring, counseling, and Islam heart of love as a deen of love, mercy, compassion for all humanity and all good creatures on this earth. So we have to transform our ummah to face the challenges of the 21st century in terms of the self, family, ummah, global. And I have given to you some understanding of the nature of ilmu tawheed in terms of the wujud or the essential existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many of the premises that we do in terms of categorical syllogism, there are many of them. I've given you many ideas about more than 10 videos. All right. So today I'm going to give you some idea about how you can master this ilmu kalam, cosmological argument. The first thing is you must master in terms of the concept of categorical syllogism. So categorical syllogism is part of the formal logic, the whole system of logic. So you go to Field Helper YouTube, there are more than 25 videos, will give you a good online understanding at undergraduate level in terms of Kalam cosmological argument, in terms of the philosophical approach. This is non-religious. It doesn't bring you whether, even though the Kalam cosmological argument is used by the Christians to defend the divinity of God, which is good. But anyway, they include their Trinity and so on, which we don't agree. But at least from the perspective of the oneness of God in terms of the defense for the existence, the wujud of Allah, they are using completely Imam Ghazali cosmological argument, 100%. All right. So whether it is St. Thomas Aquinas or right now, William Craig, you know, Professor William Craig and many others, they are using exactly the Kalam cosmological argument. So we Muslims must rise to the occasion and we must have a so-called Muslim with a strong basis in terms of formal logic. Logic, what is logic? The science of logic. And you study philosophy or you study Kalam, you must have this. Alright, then what is important is from the perspective of Dinul Islam, the field of knowledge. I'm going to give you an overview because once we understand the Kalam cosmological argument as well as the argument insofar as the wujud of Allah, then they will have the 20 sifat. What is wajib for Allah, what is wujud, kidam, baqa and so on, the 20 sifat which I am going through. Part of it I have gone through, but I'm reversing back again to give you the three basic understanding in terms of the theology of Islam. Very important basis. So the field of knowledge in terms of the field of Dinul Islam is one is theology. And this theology regards to al-ilahiyat, discuss the things that relating to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And al-ilahiyat has many sub-types, which I'm going to give you in terms of the logical, cosmological argument. Alright, so first we must know about Allah. Then we must know about prophecy. Al-nabawiyat, things that discuss to prophets, Rasul, Nabi and so on. So what are the sifah of our Rasul in terms of conveying, in terms of fatana, in terms of amanah and so on. So the sifah of our prophet and what is bring. And then linked to that is also the authenticity reporting evidence, as-sama'iyah. As-sama'iyah discuss things relating to information published that is not obtainable except for authentic report from the rim of the as-sama'iyah. So as-sama'iyah is, for example, we're talking about heaven and hell, talking about eschatology, talking about what is going to happen in the future and so on, talking about the nature of man, talking about the nature of the ruh and so on. So these are all coming from the Quran, also coming from the prophecies of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, also coming from the ilham of the our great scholars, all right, and the firasat and the basira, the opening that they get, and the tajalli that they get. So all these things are basically not intellectual. So from The intellectual predication, al-ilahiyat, we can talk it, we can say it is intellectualization of understanding Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from his perspective of his sifah. Alright? But the sama'iyah expect is something that you cannot grasp intellectually because it is beyond space, beyond time, and beyond the physical realm. So these are the report from our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or from Prophet Jesus, or Prophet Moses, or Prophet all the other prophets before them. So these are special issues which we'll discuss later in terms of ilmu kalam. But today I'm going to give you the idea of al-ilahiyat. Al-ilahiyat is the intellectual predication of three types. One is al-wujub, essentiality. So if you talk about the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we split into three. That is, to the subject term is intellectually perceived as essentiality, necessity. So what is essentiality and necessity for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Therefore, al-wajib, the essential, has been defined as that, an attribute, the non-existent of which is not perceivable to the intellect. That means al-wajib is, it is wajib that the wujud of Allah is proven intellectually. So that proving of the intellectually, that's where they come with the ilmu kalam. So that's where we have this categorization of first with the wajib, al-wujud, that becomes the essential, al-wajib. And what the first sifat is wujud. Qidam, before qadam, qidam is wujud, qidam baqa. So wujud is actually an extension of the existence, of the proof of the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the first. The second is al-istihalah. Al-istihalah is the absurdity or impossibility. Is a predication which the relation of the predicate term to the subject term is intellectually perceived as an absurdity or impossibility, mustahil. So these are the sifat that is mustahil. For example, Allah is wujud. It's mustahil for him not to have wujud. Allah is existent. It's impossible for him to have non-existence. So these are the sifat. So whatever sifat that we have in terms of wajib or the essentiality, we also have the opposite. All right, in which we call the al-istihalah. So all the al-istihalah comes about with the aspect of it is mustahil for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have the weaker, or the, for example, Allah is wujud, he the opposite of not wujud, that means non-existent, is mustahil for him. And all the other sifat, when you talk wujud, qidam, baqa, mukhalat, and so on, they are the opposite, which I've given to you in the earlier, all the 20 sifat and its opposite. So we have 20 essential attributes, 20 impossible or mustahil attributes, and then we have al-jawaz or possibility. It's a predication in which the relationship of the predicate term to the subject is intellectually perceived as a possibility. It can be or not be. Therefore, al-jaiz, the possible, has been defined as that, i.e. the attribute, the existence or non-existence of which it are valid in the intellect. That means Allah has this possible attribute to create the universe or not to create the universe. It's possible to create you or not to create you, to create me or not to create me, to create a new universe or not a new universe. It's all possible because he is all-powerful, omnipresent, omniscient, and he is also have will. So all the sifa from the 20 attributes give him the possibility of creating something out of non-existent. So these three aspect of intellectual predication is very important, fundamental for you when you want to study ilmu tauhid kalam, cosmology. You must know. We are discussing only in the aspect of al-ilahiyat right now, all right, for maybe another 50-60 videos. The prophecy aspect and nabawiyat will come on later, and the asama'iyat we will then also discuss, because what is important from the al-ilahiyat, we have to also to know what are the issues relating to our existence and its relation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in which I will give you in the next video. Because once you understand that, then you understand the whole framework of Deenul Islam. Beautiful, rational, logical, consisting of the intellectualization of the categorical syllogism, logic, so it's logical, but also bringing in the realm of knowledge beyond our perception. Remember, from the consciousness, supra-consciousness, universal consciousness, and the realm beyond us. But all these realm are being experientially experienced by our Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by Prophet Moses, Prophet Jesus, and all the great prophet, like Rasulullah, have his mi'raj. What does he see his mi'raj? He transcend the physical realm to a higher realm, in relation to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he saw many miracles and many of the issues that we study in Isra and Mi'raj. That is the dream of knowledge from the Sama'iyyat. So we have to understand this, and I will give you the relationship between the theology and the Al-Ilahiyat and the Sama'iyyat together, so that we can then have a better understanding of this deen, this beautiful, truthful deen that we Muslims must learn how to appreciate. And through Ilmu Tauhid Kalam Cosmology, inshallah, I can inspire you to understand and learn about this, because my teacher left behind his book before he passed on, and I have some inkling, some ideas, but not much, but I'm trying to not have this flame of truth from Ilmu Tauhid Kalam Cosmology just die off, just because this is something that we have to take on. Even though I'm not qualified to do that, I'm just putting up to inspire you, to have you go better than me, better than my teachers, and we create a new generation who can understand the whole fulfillment of the Deenul Islam in terms of the theology, prophecy, and the Sama'iyyat, and then we can then defend Islam in a way that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, always knowing we have a vision and mission in life, always striving as His Khalifa on this earth, always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, and making the world good, inshallah.